Hello everyone and welcome to Planet Zoo. Yeah, Planet Zoo. It's been a while since I played Planet Zoo, but I'm back. Yes, I'm back, people. Isn't that fun? So yeah, all you people who like me building in this game are lucky because there's a bit more zoo coming up. Not too much though, but still mainly Planet Coaster, but yeah, back in Planet Zoo a bit. But okay, what are we building today, you might ask? Well, today we're building a Bhutanese monastery, or like a Bhutanese building, something up in the Himalayas area. And this was for a contest, once again, always me with the contest. Yeah, I just like competing and gives them some nice like parameters to work in, and it's motivating, keeping it small and stuff. So yeah, the contest was to build like a zoo in a 30 by 30 area, so that's 30 wall pieces by 30 wall pieces, and it needed to be Asian themed, and I haven't really done a lot of Asian themed buildings. I did one in Planet Zoo earlier, which you can find in the Planet Zoo playlist, but besides that, not really a lot. Which is weird, because in Planet Zoo, like, Asian things are like 2/3 of the game. but yeah, so Bhutanese monastery. I wanted it to build on like a mountainside, and I used a reference picture. Like, pretty much if you use a search for like Bhutanese monastery, you get this exact building. And I just wanted to like get in the groove of Planet Zoo again a bit and just use it for the contest, because why not, you know? So first we're building a mountainside here, like a cliffside, whatever you call it, with lots of rocky rocks. And oh my god, people, I missed the foliage and the rocks in this game. Oh, it's so amazing. After coming back from Planet Coaster, like, Planet Coaster is amazing and all, and of course you have Team TK and stuff, but just the foliage in Planet Zoo, that's the best in any game, any building game, that's for sure. Like, it's just already, like, look at these pine trees, and then you build a pine tree in Planet Coaster and it's like a block. I don't know, it's just everyone is like, well, if we had Planet Zoo without animals at coasters, but they have the same foliage and stuff, like, that would be amazing. So I hope, like, if there's ever gonna be a Planet Coaster 2 in like 10 years or whatever, that we will have some nice foliage and systems, and so they learned from some feedback and stuff, but I was sure that will be fine. Anyway, we're starting with the foundations of the building itself now, and I went with the plaster pieces, the best item in Planet Zoo. Why is that, you might ask? Well, it is because they are not grid bound. And what does that mean? You don't. You can rotate them every way on every axle you want. And you can't do that with grid-based items. You have to do them all inside one building. You can only like get four angles, and you can't make them flat or anything. So yeah, that's why we're using it, because the monastery thing has like tilted walls. Yep, and so that's an interesting thing. It's fun to play around with. I also used this technique with the Tibetan, I guess, like a little building I did like way back at the launch of Planet Zoo. Very similar, but this is a bit more decorated, the Bhutanese stuff, a bit more pointy instead of like thicky. Yep, the other one was dummy thick, this is more like cleverly tall, I guess. I don't know, I like this more, to be honest. It's a bit more, I don't know, it feels more detailed or something. Well, not right now, of course, but you can see how I'm using these different like levels or like floors to really make it pop out and make it look interesting instead of having a square building. Like, don't build boxes. Like, that's the rule number one. Just try to mess around with the angles of buildings and stuff. You know the deal. And then, of course, normally you'd have an Archer in Planet Coaster, and there is actually an Archer blueprint in Planet Zoo. And Planet Zoo people might ask, what an Archer? What is it? Why would you need an Archer in this game? Well, the Archer, as I have explained in the Planet Coaster videos, gives you the best idea of scale to the guests. So it's the same size as the guests. So if you place that next to your building, you can like roughly estimate how tall your building needs to be relatively to a real life example, like a real building. and not that you have like a house of two stories that is like 40 meters tall, which is exaggerated, but that stuff sometimes happens in Planet Coaster at least. Planet Zoo does it better with the scaling, all of the objects are correctly scaled. Planet Coaster, we have like the old buildings, the old items are just really big, like the fairy tale stuff, and they're pretty much unusable in a lot of cases in if you want to build to scale these days, and that's why Team TK is so important to Planet Coaster as well. Luckily they did a really good job in Planet Zoo already, but still a nice reference to use when you're building a complicated building and you're trying to go for scale. Anyway, I've already built a lot of stuff here, and I'm using a lot of different colors for this build. Red, mostly red and white, and then some yellow accents here and there. And again, I'm using a reference picture, so if you think, hey, how does he think of all this stuff? Well, I'm just literally copying an image. It's still like, I guess the time and effort goes into copying it, and just looking very carefully at where everything is. And yeah, this build is more or less just straight up. At least this building is straight up from an image. So yeah, keep that in mind, so it's just not completely original or whatever. But the rest of the park in the next episode, this is a 2-episode series, will be completely by my own design, I guess. Yeah, so first off, we have this little like yellow beam thing here that is a bit curved. It was so fun playing around with all these different angles in this build, because nothing is really straight in the was really straight in this image. So yeah, you see me messing around with the axis tool a bit to get the right thing I want. I wonder how this would work in a console edition of this game. Now, I know there isn't one yet, but it probably will be, just like Planet Coaster. Like, would it be as easy to build? I still haven't messed around with the console edition myself, because there's really no need for me. But I might take a look at it later, you know. Maybe the Zoom one as well. This copying this little detail here. And then some aspects on there with the flowers. The thing about Planet Zoo is that really frustrated me to in building. Like, the foliage and stuff is amazing, as I told you, as well as the animals. But you can't recolor a lot of the pieces, and that is so frustrating. Especially if you're building something, you think, oh, I'll recolor that aspect in a bit, and then you can't for some reason. I think they said like it has to do with like keeping the original intention of the textures or whatever, but like, what is the point of that? You know, if you want to use the original text, we use that. I mean, give us just a tiny bit of freedom that makes it such less of a hassle to build the thing I want. It's just, yeah, it's a big frustration why I also don't play this game very often. It's just limiting. Luckily the plaster pieces are, and most of the wood pieces are, but then just some other important things aren't recolorable. And luckily they have picked up on making that a thing in the DLC. So they're heading in the right direction with it. But still, things on the base game, I don't know if they can update that, but that would be really amazing. That's my most critical point of feedback. The thing I love about Planet Zoo as well is the terrain stamp tool. I forgot how much I used that previously. When going back into Planet Coaster, but yeah, really glad that is in this game. You see me building these windows here, and they're at an angle just like the wall, so that was a bit tricky to do, but the windows itself are straight, so you have this light, this little like thing in the wall, some depth, and it really helps selling the whole vibe. And I just copied that around a couple of times. I'm not showing you everything I'm doing here, just the things that are new, so I don't repeat like the same thing to you guys. That's what I'm trying to do these days, as I explained before. But yeah, oh, here I'm building like a little balcony thing, which is really interesting. There's some blue aspects of this little balcony, and that's that way you get like a lot of different colors. Like, oh, these pillars, for example, the African pillars, they aren't recolorable, so you're stuck with those colors, which is sad, because I wanted like that blue, that, like, what is it, like cyan. I wanted it to be that more of a deep blue, but you can't do that, for example. It is the major thing here, but it can be quite frustrating in other scenarios. But oh well, it is what it is. It's still a fun game to build in, for sure. And I guess I'm not really into the animals. I like animals, but not as much as I like coasters and theme parks. I guess that's it. So if you're asking why doesn't he play Planet Zoo so much, it's just because I'm not as much into zoos as I'm theme parks. Still a great game, especially as far as Zoo Simulators goes. This is the best one ever, right? Same with Planet Coaster. But yeah, it's just, it doesn't really interest me as much as Planet Coaster does with the theme of it. Still fun to go back to once in a while, like now, and also to finish up the other parks, how we'll do that. But yeah, okay. Oh, by the way, I got my new computer. Well, roughly, like, I caved in and bought a 3060 instead of waiting for my 3080 that I ordered. Still for way too much money. But if I'm clever, I can sell it again later and even make a profit and stuff. But it's just like I had all the other like components are amazing and I need it. So it's like so refreshing to finally be able to play games with a normal frame rate without any issues. No lag. It's just so freeing, you know. But yeah, finally, I'm a happy camper. I can do what I want now, mostly. It still isn't like quite optimal for most things. For all things, I mean, but it's definitely more than capable of playing Planet Coaster and Planet Zoo. My previous system was, like, also if you were in an empty park, but as soon as you hit like, the higher piece counts, it will start to lag a bit. But not today anymore, I guess. I haven't really played a lot of Planet Coaster, just did some benchmarks, and it's, like, such a big difference. I can't wait to finally do some more stuff and also continue my Assassin's Creed series. I know this isn't very popular, but I really do enjoy playing those games, so I can't wait to get back in those. And here are some more golden, like colored buildings. And yeah, we already built quite a lot already. I mean, we only like how many minutes into the video? Like 10? I don't know. But yeah, it took me quite a while to build this. I think for the monastery itself, it took me like 10 hours. And then for the rest of the park, probably another 10 hours. I'm not quite sure. But yeah, it does take me quite a while to build these things. If I could build in one sitting, it gets quite tiring. So it might, yeah, sometimes it might just take a bit more time to make these videos. In case you missed it, I enabled the memberships on the channel, and that way you can become a part of the channel and support the channel and get like perks and stuff, get early access to new videos and updates, blah de blah de blah. So yeah, if you're really into the content and would like to support me in making it, yeah, hit the membership button next to the subscribe button. You would be like the real MVP, you know, would be amazing. This is the little roof building, and you have this like different layers of roof inside this Bhutanese monastery thing, and I had fun playing around with that. Lots of like different layers and depth effects to put into there. It's not just a wall, like if you see, it's already like 40 50 pieces, as you can see with the different things coming out of it. The only disadvantage of building like this is that the inside of the buildings you can't use because there's all these like wooden beams sticking out and stuff. But I wasn't planning on using that anyway here, so I think it isn't such as a big issue here. And then here I had to make a custom roof because the roof piece that I wanted wasn't in the game, which isn't a big deal. Well, it was in the game, but it was a different color and I couldn't recolor it, so I had to build it custom. And you can see how much work that can be and maybe get my frustration sometimes with not being able to recolor all this and stuff. And yeah, so but yeah, this is how you build like a custom shape like this and you copy it around. But it's really piece intensive, and luckily in Planet Zoo that isn't such a big issue. But in Planet Coaster that can be if you're running a bit high on piece count. And then here we have some detailing on the back, and then this and another balcony thing, I think. I'm trying to use a bit more of that blue accent that really works well with the rest of the build, I think. And put some nice spark of color in there. And yeah, pretty happy how that turned out. And boom, there's the another building. It's basically constructed the same way as the other buildings, so I just skip ahead if you don't mind. The roof is just copied, and except we have red tiles instead of golden ones here. I really like the gold and red tiles of these buildings. Really cool. Yeah, Asian themed buildings are like so unknown to me, but still really mesmerizing. But I mainly build like European American stuff. It's just, I don't know, more familiar to me, so it's more exciting to work on. Maybe I should like go a bit more in depth, just building that way, or building Asian stuff for Planet Coaster as well. Anyway, yeah, we're like roughly rounding up the building here, just some lower levels, and that makes the building complete. And then afterwards, you will see a finished build with like some extra foliage added that will be next episode. But I just wanted to show you the finished result anyway. I'm building the back facade here now. You can see the real life thing is like constructed like on the side of a mountain. This is more on top of a mountain, but still. Yeah, anyway, thanks for watching so much, and see you guys next episode. Bye!